What is up, everyone? Request day from Facebook and Twitter. I had a request to operate both the SP1200 MIDI to the ASR-X. And I had never done this before. I usually just use the SP1200 as a standalone. So I'm going to talk about what I found out, how I do it, and follow up with a video about what I came up with. So to start with, the SP1200, unlike most modern drum machines, will only transmit on a bass channel. You have 1 to 16, whichever one you want to choose. But the problem you will run into is that your internal sounds will also play along when you trigger your external sounds. So how do you avoid this? How do you get the SP1200 internal sounds to play when you hit a pad without triggering, obviously, your external unit, which in this case is the ASR-X? So what I've done, and I suspect this is the way it is done, is to set a note range. The pads on the SP1200 correspond directly to those on a MIDI keyboard. You have four banks on the SP1200, bank A, B, C through D, with eight pads of each. So on this particular track, what I did was I used bank A for my internal SP1200 sounds, which was drums, a couple samples, and that's it. I used bank D and bank C and used those for my ASR-X sounds. So I set the note range of the ASR-X only to respond on those pads that corresponded with bank D and bank C. And on the ASR-X, what I used was all the main samples, the vocal samples, which you'll hear. And that's pretty much what I did. We're going to have a listen to what I came up with now. That's going to be it. I'll see you on the next video. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you do when you're using the SP1200 as a controller to trigger other sound modules or drum machines. As always, thanks for watching. Subscribe to me here on YouTube. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me on Instagram. And as always, remember to go to my website, thedaydreamsound.com, and purchase my music. Peace.
Good.
Turn the bass up.